I love the way you talk to me when nobody is listening.
For people who don't know me, I am a USC graduate student. I am doing master's in computer science. I am currently a SWE intern, software engineer intern at Microsoft, and I am doing internship during the summer. Starting with what is GHC and why is it so much important and why do people spend so much to attend this particular event, especially women? It's an event which takes place for 3 days, where there are like keynotes and there are speakers and there's like expos and one-on-one meetings. There is an organization called anitab.org, which is an organization run by women. They do a Gracehopper celebration every year, which is like the conference where big companies and different startups and different industries all around the US, and basically US but all around the world, participates, and they come directly to talk to you. I'm gonna tell you what I did and how was it for me. I attended virtually. A lot of people asked me about my experience because I attended GHC 21, and for me, when I attended it was just a virtual event. But they are going back in person this year, and a lot of people asked me if they should spend the money that the event asked for, because if you have to fly to the GHC event, which is gonna take place in Florida, it's gonna cost around like $1,500. So that's a huge amount, and you should definitely think before going there that whether it's going to be beneficial to you or not. From GHC, first reason definitely is for the one-on-one meetings. So the one-on-one meetings were very impactful. You can talk to the recruiters, ask them questions, and see if they can fit you in any of the positions that they have to offer. And it also helps you in boosting your confidence in interviewing with the companies, because generally the questions that they ask in your one-on-ones is definitely the same that you're gonna get asked in your interviews as well, apart from the technical portions of it. Also, like, you talk on a video call, and generally these days also because of the pandemic, the interviews that happen in today's world are virtual. There are a lot of people who are camera shy, so definitely if you're a camera shy person, these one-on-one interviews will boost your confidence talking to people, because think about the criteria that you're talking to, like 15 or 16 different people in a span of 3 days, and that's through one-on-one, and all of them are formal. How much that's going to impact your speaking skills and your confidence and the way you talk or the way you present your profile or the way you represent yourself. So that was quite impactful for me, and I will recommend that if you want to attend GHC, this should be your first reason as well to attend GHC. The second reason why I attended and why you should attend is definitely the speeding up of process getting selected into companies. So I don't know like how to put it into less words, but then most of the companies that attend GHC, they provide you with special links which are specially for GHC attendants. And then if you apply to the companies or the roles through those links, the process that's gonna take, for example, like 10 steps will take 5 steps for you. So there were like too many companies that I applied to before GHC, and I never heard back from them for months. But then once I applied through GHC links to the same companies, I received emails in 2 to 3 days saying that please interview, schedule an interview with us. So there were like companies like TikTok, Netflix, or Google, Facebook, Amazon, Visa, and all of them. And then they were like, apply through these links within 2 to 3 days. We're gonna reach out to you in the next week, which is a very good thing, because it's a surety now that your profile is going to get evaluated, and then your profile is going to be seen by the recruiters, and then they're going to make a decision within a week, which is a very good thing. I cannot emphasize on this much, like, it is a very good thing to have your results back in a week. The third reason why I attended and why you should attend and why I liked GSE so much was just before the event, like event started in September, but then we were given a portal where we had access to all of the companies that are open right now for recruiting, and we can go directly to the portal, access that portal, and through that portal apply. So you must have seen like jobs page on LinkedIn or Indeed or similar websites. So it was a portal just like that, which was created by GHC, and all of the companies that are open right now, you can directly apply from that portal. And that was very nice because I applied to hundreds of companies through that page, and I received a lot of company reached back to me on that. And it was also like, it made my process hassle free because I don't have to go to several of the websites to see like what is open right now and where can I apply and what to do and what not to do and blah 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 blah. So it was just like one portal. I used to go to that portal every day, used to apply to all of the roles that I want to apply to, and it made my process a little easy. The fourth reason that why you should attend and why I attended was, apart from one-on-ones, there's like a group like calls going on, and there are like companies are talking, there are like company events or something like that going on every now and then. And then that's a nice thing because you can just go in there and ask the recruiter if they are they're comfortable connecting with you over LinkedIn, and if they say yes, then you have one connection in the LinkedIn, which is a recruiter connection, which is hard to get. So that was also like very beneficial in my point of view. The next thing you should attend a GHC is for the speakers, for the keynotes, and for the leadership that comes to GHC. It is at par with every other like top events that you see in leaderships, and it is a women-oriented organization, and it's like too good to be just in those 3 days, too good to feel, because you don't see a lot of let's talk real, and then you don't see a lot of women in tech even right now, and the ratio is always not equal. So it's good to see that there are like thousands of women attending the same event, and then they're like women talking for women and by the women and then whatnot. Like it's too good to be there. Coming to like whether you should attend in person or virtual, I don't know and I cannot say how beneficial it is to go in person or virtual, but definitely like if I'm talking to someone over face to face, it will be very much better than talking to a person virtually. I would definitely suggest that if you want to attend, go in person. It will be an amazing 3 days of your life. I am not sure how the career fair is going to happen in person, but I have heard like from the previous years when there was in-person events that it used to be like a normal career fair that you go to in your universities and you just take your resumes and then go talk to a recruiter one-on-one and see that. So that's also like beneficial because in a way that you can talk to multiple recruiters, you don't have to sign up for everything that you have to do in virtual. I don't know how in-person things work, but then I'm assuming that there shouldn't be any signups for it. So in virtual, there was always a limit on number of signups a recruiter can have in a day. So if you are just like late to the party, so in that case, the one-on-ones are already out for a particular recruiter and you will never get a chance to talk to them. So in that way, in-person event will be very good. Also, the keynotes to attend in person will be amazing, and you will be surrounded by people of same mindset for 3 days, which is also an amazing thing. So yeah, if you can afford it and if you can go, like definitely attend in person. But if you cannot, virtual is also good. Just get access to that portal that I was saying, the job portal. If you're spending $200 just to get access to that job portal, I would definitely suggest you to go just for that. But then now think in a way that with $200, like you're gonna get not just that job portal, but also the special links and also the LinkedIn connections and also a way where you can train yourself to interview. And it is just like a full pack thing. Like from that $200 that you're gonna spend to buy a ticket to GHC, you can build your future with that. So definitely GHC, go for it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm gonna go and see you in the next. That's all. Bye.